Hello friend, in this video, you will learn that how to make this ship animation in Blender. So let's switch to Blender, and this is default scene of Blender, but we'll start this tutorial with default scene. But we'll delete this light, so select this light, then press delete key to delete this. Now select this cube, then click on this modifier properties. Then click on this add modifier, then select here ocean. Now we have to change repeat value of x and y, that is 3. Okay. Now we have to also change this special size, that is 30. Now we have to animate this. So make sure you are at first keyframe, then under this time, click on this insert keyframe. Okay. Now click on this arrow to jump on last keyframe. Now change its time value, that is 20. Okay. Now click on this insert keyframe. Now press T for interpolation mode and select here linear. Okay. Now press space bar to play this animation. Now we have to find best position for this scene. Then select this camera, then press Alt Control 0 to snap with this viewport. Now press N for this side panel. Now click on this view and enable this camera to view. Now you can adjust from here. Now we have to add ship in this scene. So I have already created ship for this tutorial. I will put link in description so you can download from there. Now click on this file and under this append option and open your folder. Select blend file, then open collection and select collection. Okay. Now first we have to rotate this. So select this ship, then press R, then G, then minus 90 degree. Okay. Now press 0 for camera view. First we have to select this ship. Now press G, then Y to move on Y axis like this. Now select this camera and first we have to adjust like this. Now press Shift A, under this mesh select plane. Now press Tab to enter into edit mode. Then we have to subdivide this. So right click and select here subdivide. Then expand this subdivide option. Now change number of cuts, that is 100. Now click on this modifier properties, then click on this add modifier and select here shrink wrap modifier. And under this target, we have to select here cube. Okay. Now press tab for object mode. Now when you move this plane, you can see that this is following this ocean. Now we have to adjust position of this plane. So select this and move on Y axis like this. Now click on this arrow for first keyframe. Now press I and select here location. Then click on this arrow and change its position on X axis. Now press I and select here location. Now press space bar to play this animation. Okay. Now select this ship, then click on this object constraint properties, then click on this add object constraint and select here location. Now under this target, we have to select plane. Now you can see that this ship is moving with this plane, but this is not floating on water. So how to fix this? So select this plane, then press tab for edit mode. Make sure all the vertex are selected. So press A to select all the vertex, and you can see in this wireframe view. And now click on this object data properties, then click on this vertex group, and now click on this assign. Switch to object mode. Also enable this solid viewport. Now select this shape under this constraint, under this vertex group, select here group. Now press space bar to play this animation. You can see that this ship is floating on this water. Now we have to add sunrise scene. Before adding sunrise scene, make sure you are enable this add-on, that is image as plane. Okay, first enable this, then click on this add. Under this image, select here image as planes. Now open this. This is image. Now click on this import image as planes. Now we have to change its position. So press 7 for top view. Move on Y axis. First we have to change its rotation value, that is 90 degree. Now press 0 for camera view. Now press S to scale. Now press 0 for this camera view. Just select this camera and adjust little bit. Now press G, then Z to move on Z axis. And you have to adjust many times its position. Now we have to assign material on this ocean. So switch to shading workspace. Now press 0 for this camera view. Then click on this arrow and decrease this world opacity. Now select this ocean. Okay. And select this principal BSDF. Then press delete key to delete this. Now press Shift A and search here mix shader. Connect this shader point with this surface point. Select this mix shader, then press Shift D to duplicate. Now connect this shader point with this shader point. Now press Shift A and search here emission. Now also duplicate this by pressing Shift D. Okay. Now connect this emission with this shader and also with this shader. Now press Shift A and search here glass and select here glass BSDF. Now connect this point with this shader. Now press Shift A and search here attribute and connect this color point with this color and name here foam. And also change its strength value, that is 80. Okay. Now press Shift A and search here RGB. Connect this color with this color point and also connect this color point with this color point. Now change its color into blue color like this. Now press Shift A and search here Mix RGB. Now connect this color point with this factor. Now press Shift A and search here layer weight. Now connect this Fresnel with this first color. Now press Shift A and search here color ramp. Now connect this color with this second color. Now switch to render preview mode and also change its color something like this. Now click on this modifier properties under this form, give its name that is form. Make sure this name and this name should be same. Okay, now press space bar and you can see this. You can increase and decrease strength of this foam like this. And you can also increase and decrease darkness of this water from here. Only we have to adjust its color ramp handle, something like this. Now select this image and also change its shader. So select this principal VSDF and press delete key to delete this. Now press Shift A and search here emission. Connect this color with this color. Now connect this emission point with this surface point. You can see this is a very cool scene. Press Shift A under this mesh, select here UV sphere. Now press 0. Now press 7 for top view. Press G then Y to move on Y axis. Now press G then X to move on X axis. Press S to scale. Now press G then Y and we have to keep it in front of the sun. Okay, now click on this new and delete this principal VSDF node. Now press Shift A and search here emission. Connect this emission point with this surface point. Change its color like this and also increase its strength. Now click on this render properties, enable here bloom option. Now we have to add particle system as smoke. Okay, so switch to this layout and switch to this solid preview mode. Now press 0. Now press Shift A under this mesh, select here UV sphere. Select this sphere, then holding Shift, click on this Shift, then press Ctrl P and select here object. Okay, now it will move with this Shift. Now select this sphere, then under this particles properties, click on this plus and select here emitter. Now change number of particles, that is 10,000, and also change its lifetime value, that is 25. We have to also change its end frame value, that is 250. Under this render, we have to change render edge from hollow to object. Now press Shift A under this mesh. Select here UV sphere. Select this UV sphere under this object. Under this instance object, we have to select here sphere 0.002. And you can see this is not working properly. So, what we have to change under this value city, we have to change z value, that is 5, and also change x value, that is minus 5. Now press spacebar, and you can see that this is working properly. And you can adjust value from here. Now press 0 for camera view. Switch to render preview mode, and also switch to setting workspace. Now select this sphere, then click on this new. Delete this principal BSDF, press Shift A and search here emission, and you can see its color is changed. You can also change its size, so select this. Now press S to scale. If you want to adjust scene color, so under this render properties, under this color management, if you want to make a splatter of water, you need to make particle system like we made already. Okay, then you have to parent with this shape. Now click on this output properties. Now select your directory. Now select your file format. Then click on this render and select here render animation. Thanks for watching this video. Leave your comments and subscribe this channel.